Governor, thank you for being here.
Well, thank you. Nice to be with you this evening.
And first, I want to start with saying congratulations on your re-election victory.
Well, thank you very much. We're pleased to have that over with.
Let's talk about Fort Benning, where a tribute to the troops is coming from this year. How important is this Army base to the state of Georgia?
Well, it's very important. Certainly, it is the place where we train our infantry soldiers. It has been the home of the infantry school for a very long time, and more recently now the new armor school that has moved here. It is important for our state from an economical standpoint because we have a lot of civilian employees in addition to the military personnel and their families that live here while they're attending training classes or while they're staffing the positions here at Fort Benning. So it's important to our state, and we're just pleased that you're here to give this tribute to the troops.
Now, you're an Army veteran yourself, from what I understand.
I am. In fact, my years in the Army started with an ROTC career where I went to summer camp right here at Fort Benning many years ago.
And you were also based in Augusta, is that true?
I was. Fort Gordon is another one of our Army installations over in the Augusta area on the other side of our state.
Being a veteran, you obviously understand the importance of the holidays for especially the young men and women who are serving overseas. This is the 12th year that we've done this with WWE, and the first number of years we actually went to Iraq and Afghanistan. For us, it was a humbling experience because they're the true heroes. They're on the front lines, they're fighting for our freedoms, and just a little bit that we can give back to make the holiday season a bit better for them.
Well, that's certainly true. They are the true heroes, and many of them are still overseas in assignments around the world, but more and more of them are returning back here to our bases, such as Fort Benning. And it's important when they come home that they feel like that they have been welcomed back to our great country, and that they're made to feel comfortable and welcome, and that their families are able to be reunited with them. And certainly during the Christmas season is a great time for that to occur.
So being the holiday season, we'd like you now to offer your holiday greetings to the young men and women serving in the armed forces.
Well, thank you all for your service. We are very proud of you. We want to wish you the very best during these Christmas holidays. Come home safe. We are proud to have you representing us around the world, but we also are looking forward to having you back home.